كلش بسيطة للي فات، حتى شوية بس تتذكرون ايش كان اخذنا وايش راح نكمل اليوم. مثل ما تعرفون اليورينري سيستم is the system that is responsible for production of urine. This is the main function of the urinary system. والurine بحد ذاته very important for removing all the waste products from our body and maintaining homeostasis and maintaining water balance, maintaining the pH in our body. The kidney is the organ, the most important organ in the urinary system طبعا مثل ما تعرفون. The kidney consists of outer cortex and inner medulla, and the most important functional unit, أو هي the only functional unit in the kidney, هي نسميها the nephron. النفرون مثل ما أخذناها بأول محاضرتين consists of a renal corpuscle. Here, this is spherical structure. Here is the renal corpuscle, followed by a series of tubules that collect the filtrate from the renal corpuscle through a series of tubules to the ureter, then to the urinary bladder, and then to the outside of the body. Histologically, on the light microscope, we can see this is a section of the kidney. All these rounded structures are renal corpuscles. Renal corpuscles, and these renal corpuscles only found within the cortex of the kidney. We cannot see a renal corpuscles within the medulla. مثل ما نشوفه هوني هذا الكورتكس، راح نشوف ال renal corpuscles within the cortex. However, in the medulla there is no renal corpuscles. These cross sections of proximal convoluted tubules and distal convoluted tubules that will collect filtrate from the renal corpuscles to the collecting duct. This is here. This segment here is called the medullary ray, which is a series of longitudinally running tubules through the cortex to the medulla. اللي هي هاي المنطقة. هاي هي medullary rays. اللي هي in the center we have a collecting duct, and on each side we have the citrate parts of the nephron, اللي هي proximal citrate, distal citrate, and as well as the loop of Henle. And we have also the vasa recta, اللي هي blood vessels accompanying the loop of Henle down to the medulla. هاي تشي سريع. هاي صورة مكبرة أكثر للرينال corpuscles. هاي المنطقة نسميها الجلوميرولوس، اللي هي tuft of capillaries within the renal corpuscles. And this is the foramen capsule that surrounds the renal corpuscle. يقسم إلى two layers، اللي هي parietal layer and visceral layer. In between them is the urinary space. أو مثل ما قلنا we have two poles within the each renal corpuscle. We have a vascular pole and we have a urinary or tubular pole. هاي again هو عبارة عن صورة درسناها بالمحاضرات السابقة، وهي عبارة عن cross sections مأخوذة من هاي المنطقة. أخذت لي شوية من renal corpuscle اللي هي هاي، وأخذت لي جزء من proximal convoluted tubule اللي هي هذول اللي لونهم أعمق، والdistal convoluted tubules أيضا we can see cross sections. وأنا عندي several differences between the cells of the proximal convoluted and distal convoluted tubules اللي راح تمكنني إنه أميز which type of tubule is this، اللي راح تاخذونه ان شاء الله بالمختبر الاسبوع الجاي. فيعني هاي شويه راح تعطيكم فكره، تعملوا ريكابينج، ممكن انه ما تقرون المحاضرات من ترجعون للمختبر، لكن هاي انا اعطيكم شويه فكره للي راح يجيكم بالمختبر الاحد والاثنين ان شاء الله. اوكي، اذا انا عندي several characteristic features اللي انا اطيق اميز بيها من خلال proximal convoluted و proximal citrate مع ال distal convoluted with distal citrate tubules. The loop of Henle is a very thin loop resembling a capillary in the section in histological sections. ولهذا احنا ما راح ناخذه لا بالعملي، اخذناه شويه تعرفنا عليه وبالنظري بالمحاضرات السابقه، لكن بالعملي ما راح ناخذه. اوكي، اذا محاضرتنا لهي اليوم تبدي بالكولكتنج تيوبيول. مثل ما قلنا نفرون is the basic structural unit of the kidney, consists of renal corpuscle and followed by a series of tubules اللي هي proximal convoluted tubule with proximal citrate, loop of Henle, ديستال كونفوليوتد تيوب، ديستال سيتريت عفوا، وبعدين ديستال كونفوليوتد تيوبيول. ذا كولكتنج تيوبيول ويل ستارت افتر ذا ديستال كونفوليوتد تيوبيول، هي هاي المنطقه اللي مأشر عليها بالليزر هسه، سموها collecting a tubule اللي راح تاخذ الفلتريت from the distal convoluted to the collecting duct and it is a small segment. طبعا between the collecting tubule with distal convoluted we have a very short segment نسميها connecting segment اللي هي الخلايا بيها راح transitionally transform from the cells of the distal convoluted to the cells of the collecting tubule. لكن هاي it is difficult to be identified histologically. Okay, the collecting tubule, the main import, the main function of the collecting tubule is the concentration of urine together with the collecting duct. Most of the water absorption in the nephron happen in the cells of the collecting tubule and collecting duct. Okay. طبعا هو absorption of water rate of absorption of water depend on the hydration of the body. مثل ما قلنا سابقا بالمحاضرات السابقة if we are in a state of dehydration then the collecting tubule cells and collecting duct cells will reabsorb much of the water that is filtrated by the renal corpuscle. However, if we are drinking more water, there will be a secretion of more water into these structures to be voided outside. خلينا نتعرف على الخلايا اللي تكون لي ال collecting tubules وال collecting duct. So the collecting tubules are lined by two types of cells only. Two types of cells. They are either clear cells according to their histological feature. We named them as either clear cells or dark cells. So this is an electron microscope feature of the collecting tubule. We can see here the clear cell, which is the principal cell of the collecting tubule. They are cuboidal. Sometimes they are flat in the proximal part of the collecting system. They are characterized by having a lightly stained cytoplasm. ولهذا سميناها clear cell لأنها they have a light poorly stained cytoplasm. They contain few cytoplasmic organelles اللي هي mainly a small number of mitochondria and they have basal infoldings of their plasma membrane. Okay, this is the nucleus طبعا centrally located. The nucleus is centrally located. They have a small number of microvilli on their luminal surface. This is the clear cell. And as we said, this is the most common type of cells lining the lumen of the collecting tubules. We have another type of cell, اللي هي dark cell, seen occasionally between the clear cells, and they are also called intercalated cells. They are darker in color, as we see here. They are darker in color due to the presence of larger number of cytoplasmic organelles, mainly mitochondria. مثل ما نشوفه هوني, all these cross sections are mitochondria. They are characterized by having a more well-developed microvilli in their luminal surface, okay? And they have no basal infoldings. Okay, then this is the two types of cells lining the collecting tubule. This is a scanning electron microscope of the collecting tubule. This is the dark cell, and as we can see, all these white dots are the microvilli on the surface of the cell. طبعا مثل ما نعرف بعد الكوليكتنج تيوبيول راح يجينا collecting duct. Collecting duct. The collecting duct run vertically within the medullary rays into the medulla. Okay, and it lies in the center of a renal lobule. إذا تذكرون من المحاضرة الأولى يمكن the concept of renal lobule. إحنا قلنا a renal lobule located between interlobular arteries. In the center, we have a collecting duct, and this area here is the medullary ray. The collecting duct was passed vertically from the renal cortex into the renal medulla, and several collecting ducts will merge deep down into the medulla to form a papillary duct, اللي هو larger and more complex than the collecting duct. Okay, and as we said earlier, the collecting duct is the site of reabsorption of water together with the collecting tubule. Histologically, هنشوف ال collecting tubule. لاحظوا هذا طبعا this is a very important slide إذا شفناه خصوصا بالمختبر. The most important feature here is the arrangement of cells lining the collecting duct. هنشوفها again. هي cuboidal or low columnar cells, cuboidal or low columnar, centrally located or basally located in nucleus, small number of surface microvilli, and the most important thing is the presence or clear intercellular membrane. لاحظوا احنا مثل ما قلنا اذا تذكرون ال proximal convoluted tubule and distal convoluted tubule, they both have lateral wall interdigitation اللي تخلي لي lateral wall of the cell is indistinguishable. However, in the collecting duct, we don't have this interdigitation. ولهذا, it is very clear to see the lateral wall of the cells. فأنا بهذه الفيتشر هاي هي the most important feature اللي أنا أميز بيها ال collecting duct من ال proximal convoluted tubule with distal convoluted tubule بالعملي. اوكي؟ إذا هاي ملاحظة كلش مهمة بالعملي. ال collecting duct, the lateral wall of the cell is very evident, while in the proximal and distal convoluted tubule, and again in the proximal and distal striated tubules, we cannot see the lateral wall of the cell. Hi again, an electron microscope showing the same features of the collecting duct. These are the clear cells, اللي هي columnar cells, basally located in nucleus, very low number of cytoplasmic organelles, and a small number of microvilli in the luminal surface. These cells, why they are important? Cells lining the collecting duct and collecting a tubule. These cells are the main site of water reabsorption. And they have a special receptors for a very important hormone released from the pituitary gland called antidiuretic hormone. Antidiuretic hormone. أخذ من pituitary gland أنتم بالإندوكرين سيستم. وعرفتم إنه pituitary gland secrete a special type of hormone اللي نسمينه antidiuretic hormone. ومن اسمه antidiuretic. Anti يعني ضد. Diuretic, يعني process of enuresis, يعني يقلل الفوليوم of urine produced. يعني يقلل كمية الإدرار اللي يتكون بالجسم واللي ينطرح خارج الجسم. ف it will conserve more water in the body. عشان يشتغل هذا الأنتيديوريتيك هرمون. هاي نجي على هاي الصورة. These are the cells of the collecting duct or collecting tubule. This is the lumen of the collecting tubule, and here we have a blood vessel. Okay? Within the cell of the collecting tubule, we have certain type of vesicle, very important type of vesicle, that store a protein inside it. هذا البروتين اسمه aquaporin. هذا البروتين اسمه aquaporin. إذا أنا عندي vesicle داخله يخزن a specific type of a protein اسمينه aquaporin. Once the antidiuretic hormone bind to the receptors اللي موجودة طبعا على سطح ال collecting duct cells, we have a special receptors for this hormone. This will cause a signal for this vesicle and the protein inside it to come and merge with the cell wall. بحيث هذا البروتين بدل ما يكون stored within the vesicle راح يصير جزء من الممبرين of the cell. في صيغة ترانس ميمبرين وبروتين، يعني هو بروتين على طول السيل ميمبرين، اوكي، ولهذا يسمونه ووتر شانل، وهنا اسمه اكوا بورين، هو عبارة اكوا يعني مائي، فهو يسمح بامتصاص كمية اكبر من الماء من اليومن اوف ذا كولكتنج تيوبيول. اذا صار عندي more water channels under the effect of antidiuretic hormone, صار عندي more absorption of water from the lumen of the collecting tubule to the blood, and thus the urine here will be more concentrated. The urine will be more concentrated under the effect of antidiuretic hormone. Okay, طلاب، هذا الاكشن of antidiuretic hormone على الاكوبورين بروتين اللي هو موجود داخل ال collecting tubule cells. إلى هنا بعد ال collecting duct مثل ما قلنا عندنا فقط papillary duct اللي هي ما يصير بها any absorption or any change in the composition of water from composition of the filtrate. وبعدين ال urine will pass from the papillary duct to the renal pelvis and then ureter bladder مثل ما راح نشوفه بعدين. Last part of the renal cortex amygdala اللي لازم نعرفه ولازم نتعرف علينه هي renal interstitium. Renal interstitium طبعا مثل ما نعرف انه قلناها previously انه الكني has a renal cortex and renal medulla. The renal cortex consists of most parts of the nephron اللي هي corpuscle, proximal convoluted tubule, distal convoluted tubule وبقية البرانشات مالتهم. لكن between these nephrons we have special types of connective tissue اللي هي kidney parenchyma اللي هي تعمل لي مثل المكان اللي يمسك هذول parts of the nephron together. Okay, this is called renal interstitium. واللي هو مكون من two parts, interstitial cells, interstitial cells و interstitial matrix. مثل ما نعرف ان الكورتكس is more crowded with the nephron and its branches, ولهذا the interstitial cells او renal interstitium constitute only about 7% of the volume of the cortex. However, in the medulla and especially near the papillae, it constitutes more than 20% of the volume. إذن أنا عندي مثلا هذه collecting duct. This is a collecting duct. عندي blood vessels in the area as well. لكن الخلايا بيناتهم، الخلايا مثلا هذه هي renal interstitial cells. Renal interstitial cells. Between these cells, we have a special acellular matrix اسمينه interstitial matrix. قبل ما نقول له الميدالا عشان شكله in the cortex the renal interstitium is very basic and simple in composition. It's only found of few types of cells اللي هي two types of cells, either cells resembling a fibroblast اللي هي spindle shape found between the basement membrane of the tubules. نشوفه بين التوبيولز وبين التوبيولار كابيلاريز. اوكي، بس تنطيني شيء للكورتكس. وايضا عندي ماكروفاجز اللي هي other type of cells found in the renal interstitium. However, in the medulla we have other types of cells، ولهذا انا عندي الانترستيشيوم is a little bit more complex. مكون من لوز الكتروليوسنت ماتيريال، لوز الكتروليوسنت ماتيريال اللي هو اسيلولار طبعا in nature، اللي هو interstitial matrix مكون من proteins, glycosaminoglycans, collagen fibers، عدة materials أخرى، and embedded within this matrix a special types of cells مثل هذه أسميها lipid laden cells. Lipid laden cells، لاحظوها lipid laden cells اللي هي resemble a myofibroblast to contain the most characteristic features that it contain a lipid droplet. هذه الليبيد لادن سيل resemble a myofibroblast، فبيها processes الريجولار بروسيسز اكستندد ان اول دايركشن، وتمسك لي التوبيول ان وان سايد collecting duct or whatever collecting tubule and the blood vessel الفازا نكتا in the other side حتى ايضا it conserve the structure of the medulla. Okay, and as we said, they contain a prominent lipid droplet in their cytoplasm. This is the most important parts of the renal interstitium. وبهذا نكون خلصنا كل الأشياء الخاصة بالكدني, بالproduction of urine, how the urine pass from different parts from the renal corpuscle down to the collecting duct, وإيش هي المكانات اللي هي associated with concentration of urine. بعد النفرون, okay, يدخل اليورين in a series of transport passages until it is voided outside of the body. Okay, these transport passages start from the papillary duct, اللي هي تتكون من اتحاد عدد من ال collecting duct, papillary duct. Papillary duct يفتح بالminor calyx. Papillary duct يفتح بالminor calyx اللي هو بهاي المنطقة, minor calyx مثلا. Minor calyx, several minor calyces open into a major calyx, and these major calyx open in a renal pelvis. This is the renal pelvis. هاي أخذوها بالأنومي, أتصور يعني already أخذتها. Okay, renal pelvis will lead into the ureter, then the urinary bladder. The urine will stay in the urinary, in the urinary bladder for a variable amount of time until it is voided outside the body by the urethra. Okay, خلينا نجي أول شيء نتعرف على the general structure of the transport passages because they all have the same general structure. ابتداء من اليوريتر واليورينري بلادر واليورثرا, they all have the same general structure, فنتعرف عليهم بالبداية وبعدين ناخذ a regional specification of each site. Okay, all of the excretory passages have the same general structure. That's to say they have a mucosa, and they have a muscle layer beneath the mucosa. The mucosa, مثل ما نعرف, احنا اخذناها سابقا بالGIT, the mucosa consists of surface epithelium and a lamina propria. The surface epithelium is very specific in the urinary system and it's called transitional epithelium أو urothelium. Transitional epithelium أخذتمه بصف أول, أو نسمينه urothelium, ويبدي من الminor calyx down to the first segment of the urethra. Okay, this epithelium is stratified in nature. لاحظوا مكون من عدة طبقات من الخلايا, stratified in nature, consists of, نشوفه بالسلايد الجاي, stratified in nature consists of three layers of cells. The most basal layer that is sitting on the basement membrane, هي single layer, نسميها the basal layer. Okay, after it we have several layers, from one to several layers of cuboidal or local luminar cells, اللي هي intermediate region, and then we have a superficial layer of large cells, نسميهم umbrella cells. Umbrella cells. These cells are very important. They are sometimes binucleated. They are very important to protect the underlying cells from the acidic toxicity of the urine. This is the superficial, this is the surface epithelium, and as we can see here, it is formed from basal layer, here this one here, several layers of intermediate cells, and we have the umbrella cells. These umbrella cells, مثل ما قلنا, هي large cells, most superficial, dome-shaped. لاحظوها dome-shaped cells. طبعا these cells have the characteristic of changing its shape. فthey will be a dome-shaped when the organ is relaxed. For example, the bladder. If the bladder is empty, the cells will appear dome in shape. However, when the bladder is full, these cells will distend and take تاخذ مساحة أكبر وتكون على شكل فلات، ولهذا هذا الإبيثيليوم سميناه transitional epithelium. تحت الإبيثيليوم we have a dense collagenous lamina propria. Okay. بعد اللامينا بروبريا we have a muscle layer تحت اللامينا بروبريا and it consists of only two layers of muscles اللي هي longitudinal layer. The inner one is the longitudinal layer and the outer layer هي circular layer. طبعا هي إذا نجي على actually يعني أشون arrangement of muscle cells they arranged in a spiral pattern around the ureter and around the bladder as well. However the spiral of these muscle layers is loose spiral in the inner layer. Well, you have it on a cross section, they appear as if it is longitudinal. However, in the outer layer, the spirals of the muscle is more tightly arranged. Well, you have on a cross sections, it appear as a circular layer. However, histologically, we can say it as it is a longitudinal, inner longitudinal, and outer circular layer. طبعا هذا كان general arrangement of the transport passages of the histologically of the transport passages of the urinary system. وهسه نجي على regional specification. عندي أنا certain features اللي تميز لي اليوريتر عن البلادر عن اليوريثرا. اوكي اليوريتر مثل ما تعرفون هو a tube that conduct the urine from the kidney to the bladder. It's approximately 24 to 34 centimeter in length and it is lined by a transitional epithelium. هاي احنا متفقين عليها. تحت ال transitional epithelium we have a lamina propria. Okay? Dense irregular connective tissue اللي هي lamina propria. بعد ال lamina propria we have a muscle coat اللي هي inner longitudinal و outer circular layer. لكن ايش المهم هوني؟ بالأبر part of the ureter اللي هي between the kidney down to the first two-thirds of the ureter the muscle coat is only formed of two muscle layers اللي هي inner longitudinal or outer circular. However, as we approach the bladder the ureter will have three muscle layer coats just like the bladder اللي هي نفسها هي muscles of the bladder extending for a little bit to the ureter. فأنا راح يكون عندي inner longitudinal, outer longitudinal, وmiddle circular. Okay? The outer part of the wall is the adventitia where the adipose tissue vessels and nerves can be seen in this layer. Okay, طلاب؟ بعد اليوريتر راح يكون عندي the urinary bladder اللي هي just a reservoir for collecting urine. راح يتخزن بها اليورين لمدة معينة من الوقت until it's voided outside the body. The most important feature of the bladder is that it has a very thick muscular wall. Very thick muscular wall. The muscle of the bladder is called the trouser muscle. أخذت بالأناتومي إذا أخذت من اليورينري سيستم. Okay. This muscular wall is thick and folded when the bladder is empty طبعا and the wall will be smooth and distended smooth and flat when the bladder is distended. مثل ما نشوف هوني هذا السلايد أخذنا له من الهيستولوجي جايد السيرفيس epithelium مثل ما قلنا earlier هو transitional epithelium تحته عندي layer of lamina propria وبعدين a very thick muscular coat اللي هي consist of three muscle layers. Okay? Inner longitudinal outer longitudinal and middle circular. However, there is a no sharp demarcation between this, these three layers. We have muscle cells that run in all directions تقريبا حتى تعمل لي very forceful and powerful contraction of the bladder during voiding of the urine to the outside. The urethra is the last part of the urinary system اللي هي مثل ما تعرفون fibromuscular tube conveys urine from the urinary bladder to the exterior through the external urethral orifice. يختلف اليوريثرا between the male and female in regard to size, structure and function. However, the mucosa in the first part of the urethra is the same as the other part of the urinary passages اللي هي transitional epithelium, لكن تدريجيا راح يختلف الميوكوزا بين الميل والفيميل على حسب موقع اليوريثرا من الجسم. The male urethra is about 20 centimeter in length and has three distinct segments. We have prosthetic urethra, membranous urethra, and penile sponge urethra. التفاصيل مالت موجودة بالمحاضرة ولا أنتم أيضا راح تأخذوها أيضا مور تفاصيل أكثر وأيضا سلايدات عليها أكثر بالميل سيستم. أوكي. Female urethra is much more simpler and basic than the male urethra. They are only 3 to 5 centimeters in length and it's initially lined with a transitional epithelium, حاله حال اليوريتر والبلادر, لكن هذا transitional epithelium gradually will change to non-keratinized stratified squamous اللي هو as we approach near the skin at the labia minora. So in summary, we know that the nephron is the basic functional unit of the kidney. Here we have a photo of the nephron. مثل ما نشوف different parts of the nephron, renal corpuscles, the glomerular tuft of capillaries, اللي هي glomerulus, Bowman's capsule, هذا Bowman's capsule, different tubules, نسميها حسب موقعها وحسب شكلها. فأنا عندي proximal convoluted, proximal citrate, بعدين يجي loop of Lily, distal citrate, distal convoluted collecting tubule collecting. Okay, all these areas, كل واحد منهم عنده specific function for the concentration of urine. عدة عمليات كثيرة, عمليات كثيرة تجري داخل هاي المنطقة in, by interaction of cells lining the tubules مع ال interstitial cells مع ال blood vessels اللي موجودة قليل بيمه. ممكن يكون اكو active transport, passive transport, active exchange, diffusion, كل هاي العمليات اللي اخذتها انتم بصف اول بالفيزياء, هاي اللي هي ال passage of substances between two mediums, كلها ممكن تصير within the nephron according to osmolarity of the nearby tissue according to the need of the body طبعا. اوكي, لاحظوا بكل منطقه من مناطق النفرون is specialized with absorption of certain types of material. عندي مناطق only absorption of water. لاحظوا water, 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 water بالcollecting duct mainly water. Okay, ولهذا ال concentration of urine يصير mainly بالcollecting duct. Okay, عندي other areas اللي هي specialized for the secretion of bicarbonate أو hygiene ions حتى تتحكم لي بال pH of the urine. أوكي, صحيح, عندي صوديوم وكلورايد ومغنيسيوم وكل الشغلات, كل المكانات أيضا تعمل لي secretion of creatinine toxic substances to the ultrafiltrate حتى الجسم يتخلص منه. هاي تاخذوها بالفسلجة اللي هي physiology of the renal system, تتعرفون بشكل أكبر على الفانكشنز اوف ذا نيفرونز وين يصير الابزوربشن والطرق اوف ذا ابزوربشن اوف ماتيريالز فروم ديفرنت بارتس اوف ذا نيفرون. اوكي طلاب, هاي كانت بهذا اخر محاضره من الرينال سيستم. اذا عندكم اي